Hey everybody, I hope you're doing well. I'm back with a 10th guardian from Ankh, Gods of Egypt, and this is Khepri, like a little beetle. Anyways, this is where we're going to be using some different techniques of painting here. We're going to be using some new Green Stuff World Colorshift metals. Well, two of them anyways. And one of them might actually be a mistake in the box that I got because it's not giving the color it was supposed to. Anyways, we're going to look into that. We're starting off, we got to paint certain areas in black so that these paints work wet the best, actually, because they recommend having a black base. And then I also found out you're supposed to put a gloss varnish on top of the black base so to really make them pop. And you'll see, so I'm just going to do some details here and we're going to move along to the next paint. Alright, so here we go. We're going to be using the Psychotic Illusions. So it goes from a light blue to a green to a purple to all sorts of cool colors as the light changes around it. Now you don't just put one coat of this, you let it dry, you put on another one, you let it dry, maybe put on even a third coat, just to make sure that you don't see too much of the underpaint. Alright, and then the next metallic color shift color we're using is Burning Gold. So as you see, it's supposed to go from like this bright yellow to like a orangey red when you switch, but I don't know if you're going to notice on camera, but it actually goes green. So I spoke to the person where I bought the paint set and they said it's possible that I got a mistake in it. So I don't know, I might contact Green Stuff World and see what's going on or if they know if I'm doing something wrong with this paint. But just painting with these two made me that I had to go buy the other two sets. So I've got the three sets of color shift metals. I don't know if I'm going to use them all eventually. If I had some minis to test them on, I would love to. But it's pretty much just going to show up in my videos like this whenever I paint certain areas with metal. And with the gods from Ankh, they've got a lot of silvery, golden, metallic parts. So I might end up using a lot of these just to make it a little bit different than the artwork. Hey, and if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, and if you liked the video, hit the like button. And again, don't forget to comment if you want to keep seeing these on Guardians. I'm going to keep making the videos anyways, probably, if no one responds, but if you want to just see what they look like later on, I can just post a video of everything I've painted. Now we're going to be using some Succubus Red, and this is just for like a part on its neck and a little bit underneath the belly. Oh, and parts of the legs as well. Alright, we're going to do part of the base, well actually the whole base, but the first layer. So we're going to use some Vallejo Buff. I actually should have done this first so that I don't hit the legs in that, because then I had to touch up the legs and some of the other parts. Anyways, you learn as you go. So the second one I did completely different. I actually started with the base and then painted it black and then other stuff and then came back with the other metallic colors. So yeah, if you're painting this miniature, start with the base first. All right, now we're going to use a little elemental bolt, and this is going to be for the rest of the belly underneath, the rest of the legs. It has a very nice bright blue to this miniature underneath there. As you can see too, I also primed this in crystal blue, if I hadn't mentioned that before. Ultramarine blue. I just wanted a very... I thought that the metal was going to work, the metallics paint were going to work on the blue, but it actually didn't. So that's why I painted over it in black. I actually tested that on the other miniature off camera just to see what the effect was, but you couldn't see those metallic colors. Alright, going to be using some deep blue, and honestly I don't know why I did this. I just figured I'd get the rest of the head here done with a little darker blue. Technically, I could have left that nice blue underneath as the primer and just put a wash on, a little dry brushing, a little brighter on it, but just, you know, again, you live and learn with these paints sometimes. Now we're going to be using a little bit of scar tissue on the wings, and as you can see, I go a lot more light as I go up, so I let the paint just come off of the brush a little bit more, and just so that the top part still has some blue, because in the artwork it goes like from a pinkish purple to a purplish blue. Anyways, and you'll see with the wash later on what it gives. It comes out pretty nice actually. Now we're just going to do little dabs of this ice storm on the wings here, the internal wings, just because they're going to be a little bit brighter once you put the wash on. And now we're going to do some Carabore Crimson, and we're going to put this on all the Succubus Red, just to give it a very nice darkish, a darker red, but with a wash instead of just painting it dark red. Alright, now we're going to be using a little Dreckenhof Nightshade, and this is going to go on pretty much the entire miniature that has blue, including the wings, the legs, the head, and as you can see with the wings, it's really going to change the color of that pinkish hue to purple, but it keeps a bit of that pink in the background anyways. As you can see, it still keeps some of that elemental both as well. So these shades from Citadel, I do have to say, are really good at shading and just discoloring a little bit, like not too much, and it just gives you a nice better texture, better highlighting, almost like a highlight. It's almost like a contrast paint, but a little bit better, because you're not getting paint in it, you're just getting a shade just to get what you want it to do. Anyway, so now we're using a little bit of Spirit Stone Red, just to make these little gem parts pop a bit more. Even though they stay a little darker than what I would have liked, I should have put some red underneath first and then put this on, but you know what, they still pop a little bit, and that's it. So now we're going to be finishing off the base with some Agaras Dunes, which I've used a lot of times on the miniatures in this series, just because I find it looks more like a deserty sand color. And with the base already having like some stones in it, I didn't add any of the texture earth I did in the past. So once again, I hope you're enjoying these videos. Hit that like button and comment down below if you want to keep seeing these guardians and some more Ankh. And eventually I'm going to get to the gods, which are going to be really intimidating. So as you can see there, the color shift is changing colors with the lighting. You can see the purple, the green, the blue. Amazing paint. So if you haven't tested those already, go ahead and take a look at those. And we'll catch you all in the next one.